So class 12, next practical is to isolate DNA from available plant material. So we here are using isolation of DNA from banana. We are using banana, which is the most available thing in the market. So we are using the banana and we are doing the method 2 procedure. Not the method 1, method 2 procedure. Whatever here it is written, you go through it, and according to that, I am doing one method. So, the method one we are doing, procedure method one. This is the most convenient method. You can easily understand and you can easily go through this method. Method two is little bit difficult, so we are using method one. Any one method we can do. So go through the book after the experiment. Now let's start. First, we have to take the banana, any kind of banana. Then we have to smash it in a mortar pestle. So what are the things required? Let me tell you first. By that time, let the miss do the smash thing. So we have to need a chill alcohol, that is ethanol. Ethanol itself is a chill alcohol. So we need ethanol, we need one banana, and one more thing we need. We have already mixed the things. Before that, I want to tell you what are the things that is present in this beaker. In this beaker, there is a salt, little bit of salt, little bit of distilled water or any tap water you can use, and little bit of detergent. These three things mixture is here in this beaker. Along with that, you chilled alcohol, that is ethanol itself is a chill, one banana that we have to smash it, then put some distilled water in the smash banana. Smashing of the thing is done, banana with some distilled water. Now we will take this extraction fluid in a beaker. Now we will add this mixture, that is the mixture of detergent, soap, detergent, any types of detergent. Next, we have taken salt in this thing, and we have to add with the smash banana. Next, we have to stir it for 10 to 15 minutes. 10 to 15 minutes. In between this, I will tell you the thing, that is, I have already make a note that we have to stir the mixture for approximately 10 to 15 minutes so that whatever the detergent and salt as well as the water, it will enter inside the cell. Why we have to stir it for the so long time, that is for 10 to 15 minutes, as because whatever the detergent and salt as well as the water, it enters into the cell. And why we have taken the detergent, it is written here, see, the function of this detergent is that it breaks down the wall of the cell. Actually, we have taken the detergent so that it breaks down the wall of the cell or break down the cell membrane. As a result, the nucleus can come out. If we break down the cell membrane of the banana, then the nucleus will come out. And we all know that DNA, which is present in the chromosome, or we can say the chromosome is made up of DNA. You all know that chromosome is made up of DNA, or we can say DNA is present in the chromosome, and chromosome present inside the nucleus, and in turn chromosome is present inside the nucleus, a nucleus present inside the cell, and the number of cells are there which together form this banana. So again, I am telling you, DNA is present in the chromosome. Chromosome is actually made up of DNA, both are same statement, and chromosome is present inside the cell. Chromosome is actually present inside the cell, and the number of cells which there are in the banana, which actually makes this banana. Now next, after 10 to 15 minutes we will stir it, then from this filtrate we can got the number of DNA. How next we have to filtrate it, and we have to add ethanol. After adding ethanol and this filtrate, we have to again wait for 10 to 15 minutes so that we can see the DNA become isolate on the top of the alcohol in a test tube. So wait for the next step. For 13 minutes we have done the stirring process so that the cell breaks down and the nucleus can come out, because in nucleus there is chromosome and in chromosome there is DNA. To isolate the DNA, we need to take 10 to 15 minutes to stir the whole mixture. Now we have to filter it. Let's take the filtrate out. I'm switching off the video. In between, let's the filtrate out. Then we have taken some ethanol in a test tube. We will add this filtrate. The how you have to add it, the special way is there. So that time you will see the special way of adding the mixture in the ethanol. We have filtered out the mixture. Now we have taken our ethanol in a test tube. Now we have to drop the filtrate mixture like this way. That is the side of the wall of the test tube. Test tube er ga diye porbe. Dite thako. অনেকটাই নিতে হবে, লাইক দিস ওয়ে ইউ হ্যাভ টু পুট দ্য ফিল্ট্রেট ইন দ্য টেস্ট টিউব ফিল্ড উইথ ইথেনল অ্যালকোহল। স্পেশালি ইউ হ্যাভ টু টেক ইথেনল, বিকজ ইথেনল ইটসেলফ ইজ এ চিল অ্যালকোহল। ইন দিস এক্সপেরিমেন্ট ইউ নিড আ চিল অ্যালকোহল। আরো না নাড়াবে না এখন। So the like this way we have to again put the test tube for 10 to 15 minutes. After 10 to 15 minutes we will observe that the isolation of DNA will take place. How I am telling you, the DNA portion will float on at the top of the test tube. Rekhe dao. The white fibers at the top of the alcohol are actually the DNA that separates from the banana. These are the DNA that separate out from the banana. These DNA that is at the top of the alcohol floating, they are actually appear as a white fibers.